In this, I still call it a mini banking crisis, at least for now. Joining us is Jefferies' Brent Thill to discuss that. NASDAQ 100, Brent's up, I believe, outperformed the S&P for 11 straight days through yesterday's close. What do we make of that?
Hey, David, it's just a flight to big balance sheet strength. Tech obviously had a terrible year last year, and I think we're seeing a rotation back as multiples are down. As you said, I'm marketing in Europe, seeing clients in London and Paris, and every client is concerned about what's happening in the financial sector. So I think you're also seeing the sector rotation from industrial cyclicals and banking back to tech. Ultimately, I think we're a little concerned about the magnitude of the move because fundamentals still have not improved. And we're certainly could see another downtick as it relates to the fundamental demand environment for tech. So I think this is more of a sector reallocation than any real hope of a big acceleration in tech demand. There's definitely some AI excitement, too, around what's happening with Microsoft and NVIDIA.
Sure. But to the extent that multiples are now going up, are they not going to be justified by the earnings that follow?
I think that's the risk, is that we've had a huge move. And right now we've continued to see companies not have a great top line. What we're seeing is the conviction on the bottom line. So as long as the tech it continues to control the bottom line expense, even if the top line was a little weak, I think that investors are going to give them a hall pass. And we've seen that with Meta. We've seen it with Microsoft. We've seen it with a number of companies that have had strong cost control, even if the top line's not great. Investors are giving them a hall pass, and these stocks continue to work higher on stronger expense controls. So I think, you know, the back half of the year is still a real big open question in terms of demand at this point. But I don't think from what we can see and from a lot of the tech companies we talk to that demand is falling off. It just isn't inflecting. And then we have to take into account what's going to happen with the banking sector and then some of these small startups in tech. Ultimately, their consumption of technology, is this going to create a headwind for demand in the next 3 to 6 months, given there's some distractions that are going on in those respective subsectors? That's something else that we're keeping an eye on.
Yeah, I mean, there's one line of thought, Brent, in addition to everything you've said there in terms of what's driving these flows, that also, you know, a lot of the big tech stocks kind of took their medicine in terms of the earnings estimate declines last year. Maybe there's not as much vulnerability. That gets to your cost cutting and bottom line discipline aspect. What about Amazon? It seems to be the outlier in terms of how it's been straight down. It doesn't necessarily have that real valuation support. Where does it leave it in terms of looking for a catalyst or how, in fact, investors should approach it here?
Yeah, the two biggest questions on Amazon is when is AWS going to bottom in growth? And hopefully that happens in the next couple quarters. That's their cash cow. That's the number one topic. And then number two is when do they get the retail costs aligned with demand? And they're still, you can see it in all the actions, pulling back in the second headquarter build out. Friends of ours that have warehouses, you're seeing Amazon abandon some warehouses and continue to pay rent because they have lease costs. You know, they're trying to unwind this expensive network that they built up in the pandemic. And so I think those are the two big areas that we hear. I think coming out of this, they're going to be in a good position. There's no question. Jassy, again, a software guy, cares about high margin businesses. I think ultimately they're getting a better control on their bottom line. And ultimately, AWS, from the cloud perspective, is going to emerge out of this as still the best positioned company across the cloud provider. So we're still bullish long term, but think tactically short term, there's still some challenges as it relates to employees and what they're doing in their supply chain costs. It's going to take some time for them to get full control over those expenses.
Hey, Brent, real quick, anything you picked up? You said you're marketing, I think, in Europe. I mean, any sort of difference between investors' concerns over there and here?
David, investors are underweight tech pretty massively. One of the questions I've asked in the last few days seeing clients is, are you overweight or underweight tech? And they're all underweight tech. And that also explains the move in tech, which is every investor in the institutional market, we don't talk to retail investors, they're institutions, they are underweight tech. And that is another driver that's helping the recovery, which is we're just doing a portfolio reallocation So it's not necessarily fundamentals inflecting. It's just a reallocation of dollars from other sectors. That's a big theme we're hearing.
All right. Brent, thank you. Appreciate it. Have a great weekend.